Okay guys, it's Dave here. I bought another camera here. It's the DMC-FZ300 Panasonic LUMIX. This is the long zoom. So this has a really, really long zoom on. I think it's 600mm. Yeah, 600mm. Leica DC VARIO-ELMAR at 25 to 600mm with a f2.8 power image stabilization. So I'm going to go ahead and unbox this now and give you guys a look at it. So the weird thing is it says, this is from Amazon, and it says right here, I hope you can see that, but for Japan only. What the heck? I did read something about that in the reviews, that it was for South Africa or something like that, but this one here is for Japan only. Now it says it's new and it's never been opened, so let's hope that's the case. So inside the box, looks like we've got a CD-ROM and a big thick book user manual. So optional accessories. So I wonder if this one will have an actual hard charger, like a charger, external charger type. Yes, it does. So it comes with a wall wart charger. Nice hood for the front of the lens, which I always love. Lens cap. Why wouldn't this be installed already on the lens? Like, USB cable, regular USB, micro USB, a strap, and of course the battery. I wonder if all these take the same battery pack. So this will be my third camera, a third Panasonic camera. Right now I'm shooting this on the LUMIX G85, so I'm going to need the battery. So I'm just going to set the rest of this stuff aside, except for, I'll put the lens cap on in a few minutes. But anyways, this is the camera inside this white protective bag. I've seen a couple of people review this, and theirs came in a plastic bag, so I don't understand why that would be, but let me just get the box out of the way here. We don't need this anymore. And there she is. That's got the long zoom on it. So, and yeah, this one's got the on-off switch. Right here, the on-off. Like a hard on-off switch. And if I see correctly, it's got the wide-angle telephoto on the actual trigger switch, which is what I really like. It's a built-in flash. This must be for manual focus. Oh, it's also got the telephoto and wide-angle switch on the lens itself too, which is handy. It has an external mic jack. It has the articulating clip-around 3-inch screen. I think it's a 3-inch screen. Anyways, I'm going to put this around so it can be seen. It looks like all the buttons on the back are pretty well the same as they are on the G85. Tripod mount. Battery holder. Okay, so the SD card goes in the bottom where the G85, it goes in the side, which is what I prefer. But I'm not going to put an SD card in this yet. I do have one. And then on this side we have the HDMI. A USB. Why would the HDMI be below the micro USB plug. That's strange. Anyways, it has HDMI out, so it can be hooked up to the Lilliput monitor. This camera does 4K. It also has the 4K, what do you call it, photo mode. So it's weird that the lens cap wouldn't be already on it. That's kind of strange. So the lens cap has a strap attached. And I wonder if that strap what is that for? You can't connect it to this lens. Oh, there we can. So it goes, the lens cap has a lanyard attached. These are always tricky to get in, but sometimes they're made correctly, making them easy to put in. I probably shouldn't use a knife. I got a pink paperclip here. And with this, I should be able to get that lanyard thingy to come out. I kind of always didn't like these things. They're kind of dangly, you know, pain in the rear things. Dangle off and make a clacking noise in your shot. But, and if this goes on like that, why would they put that on the other side? Anyways, there's got to be a place to hook it up. So we'll just put the cap on in a bit. So now let's stick the battery in here and have a look at the menu and so on. I think all these Panasonic cameras have pretty well the same menu set up, which is always nice. So what's going to happen here? Oh yeah. So let's go telephoto. Look at this. Come on. Oh. Asking me to set the language again. So language English, set clock. So it is, I know it's 12, but not sure exactly. 12:50. July 7. 2020. Set home area. It's Toronto, New York, Miami. Yeah. And again, it's saying there's no memory card. So this viewfinder sticks out a little bit further than the other one. It should have the same. Yep. So when you put your eye up to it, the viewfinder comes on and the display goes off. So let's have a look at the menu. Yeah, it's pretty well the same menu style as the G85. And I forgot to mention this, but it's Wi-Fi compatible. Wi-Fi, I believe, and Bluetooth as well. Bluetooth as well. So it has raw processing, photo style. So this is a format, record quality. So picture, I think 12 megapixel. I thought it was bigger than that. But anyways, that's good enough. We're printing up to 16 by 20 inches. Aspect ratio, want that 16 by 9. Picture size, large, 9 megapixel. Now it says 12. It's not 12 anymore, it's 9. What the hell? Anyways, it's a really good camera. And it has quick menu, so you can just, this is the shortened version of the menu. You can just go through this it's a little quicker than using this menu. So in display allows you to turn on and off the stuff. It has the level line. So I like the fact that it has the actual switch, because you can leave the battery in this after you've turned it off and it will not deplete the battery, or it shouldn't anyways. It has the hot shoe at the top, pop up flash, and this is the manual focus dial, I believe, right here. So anyways, now on the mode selector switch we have video, manual, we have manual, M, I think that's fully manual, S, A, P, intelligent, photo, creative, scene, panoramic, and C for custom. So it says Wi-Fi, yeah. And then again, it has the autofocus lock switch, which is always nice. You can turn the viewfinder on and off with function 4 button, mic input on the side. Yeah, so that's there it is. This is the DMC-FZ300 LUMIX by Panasonic. Anyway, guys, as always, thanks for watching. Stay tuned for some actual footage from this camera. Thanks for watching. Please rate, comment, and subscribe. Thanks.